ערב טוב. הטקס התנהל באנגלית לטובת אורחינו מחול. Head of the Dalet al-Karmel Council, Rafiq Halabi. Chairman of the Board of Governors, Professor Alfred Tauber. Chairman of the Executive Committee, Ami Alon. President of the University, Amos Shapira. Rector of the University, Professor David Faraji. Honorable members, Vice Chairman of the Board, distinguished friends and faculty, good evening. Tonight's festive opening of the 43rd Board of the Governors meeting is dedicated to the University of Haifa and all of you whom are lucky enough to count as our friends. Some come from very near in Dalet al-Karmel and Asafia, and others from further away, sometimes thousands of miles. All have one thing in common, a belief in the power of education and the commitment to allow others to reap its rewards. Through the scholarship you provide, you allowed so many different students to realize their potential, to study, and to give back to the society as educated citizens of Israel. That is a precious gift, and we dedicate this evening to all of you who make it possible. There are 18,000 students at the University of Haifa, and many are helped by your love and support. I studied for my first degree at the university, was lucky enough to get a Druze Academic and Social Leadership Scholarship, and I earned master's in the university too. And today, I teach at the Ord School in this village, and I'm a graduate student at the Education of Faculty. I earned the value of education young. I earned the value of education young, and you, our friends, helped me reap the rewards. My name is Dua Zidane, and it's an honor to be with you here tonight. And now, to open this meeting, it's my privilege to welcome to the stage the Chairman of the Board of Governors, Professor Alfred Tauber. Professor Tauber is not only a longtime friend and supporter of this university, but someone who last year came to our aid during the Operation Protective Edge to raise support for our students and faculty who were suffered by the operation. Professor Tauber, it is my honor to invite you to open the 43rd Board of Governors meeting of the University of Haifa 2015.
Thank you. Rafiq, Yona, governors, and guests, it's my privilege and honor to open the 43rd meeting of the Board of Governors. It's always fitting to have a festival and a happy occasion to open a meeting, and this is a particularly auspicious location and a neighbor of the university, which is obviously integral to our larger purpose and our larger goal. And our mistress of ceremonies is a wonderful example of the University of Haifa's contribution to the community and its ongoing commitment to education. I'd like to offer you a very short vignette. It begins in ancient Israel, Palestine, when the Romans were here. And the Romans had a rather bizarre way of having festival occasions. They would feed someone to the lions. So the story, and I'm not sure this is documented very carefully, but it goes something like this. There was this fellow, he was put into the arena, and the lion came out. He whispered into the lion's ear, and the lion shrugged his shoulders and walked away. So the emperor was very upset, sent in the tiger. The fellow stopped the tiger, whispered in its ear, and the tiger turned around and went away. The emperor was really rather upset about all of this, and he sent in a rhinoceros. Now, we all know rhinoceroses are not terribly rational. They don't listen very well. But the fellow was able to stop the rhinoceros and whispered in his ear, and he also went away. And the emperor then finally called the fellow over and said, "What the heck did you say to these animals that they would walk away and not have you for dinner?" And the fellow said, shrugged his shoulder, and said, "I said, listen, I'm the dinner. After dinner, the speeches begin." And that is the story of the evening, and that's why I'm going to stop. I do appreciate very much the hospitality of the Druze community for hosting us. We're most appreciative, and we hope that we can contribute to you just as you contribute to us. Have a wonderful evening. Please come to the events of the board, which I hope are stimulating and exciting, and I look forward to greeting you again tomorrow. Good evening.
Thank you, Professor Tauber, for these wonderful words. Like Professor Tauber, Chairman of the Executive Committee, Ami Alon, has had a long association with the university. He has given us the benefit of his incredible experience working tirelessly on the university's behalf. He's a long-standing friend of the Druze people and is close to many of the residents of Dalit al-Karmel and Sofia. Mr. Ami Alon, it is my pleasure to have you here with us tonight.
Thank you very much.
Please.
Thank you very much. My friend, Rafiq Harabi, and Yona, my friend and, in a way, my mayor. I'm the dinner. So I'm not going to be the speaker, but I want to say that for me, I feel among friends and neighbors, And I believe that there is no better place to open the board of our governors than among our friends on the Carmel Mountain, because if the whole idea of our university is to achieve academic excellence in diverse society, so this is the right place to open the board of governors. I hope that all of us, we shall enjoy, we shall learn, we shall exchange ideas. And to finish, just a small anecdote. I came tonight, and it was very easy. You know, I took my car from Kerem Maharal, and I don't know, 15, 20 minutes, I was here. And it reminded me those days when I had to, every month, to run from Atlit to Dalet El Carmel. It was much more difficult. So tonight, it was very easy, and I hope that we shall have an enjoyable evening. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Ayalon, for the insights. We hope to have many more cooperations and, of course, a long-time friendship for the years to come. Good things come in threes. The last of the university's senior management to speak tonight is the person who brings all the university achievements together to form the whole. President Amos Shapira shares the desire to strengthen our ties with the Druze communities and promote access to higher education for the Druze and for all the students, all those who need support, whoever they are. President of the University, Mr. Amos Shapira, it is my honor to invite you to the stage.
So, although I have a written speech, I will leave it aside. And why is that? Because how can I speak in English after Dua Zedan spoke so lovely with such, you know, way of speaking? I'm, you know, embarrassed to speak in English after she did it. And yes, indeed, and we'll continue with the dinner and with the... So, I am the bone. Because, you know, after the chairman of the board of governors spoke, and after the executive chairman of the executive board spoke, so what left to me is the bones. But anyhow, I really agree with the army that the fact that this ceremony is taking place here reflects more than any other symbol the real spirit of our university. Yes, our primary goal is to create excellent research and teaching. Yes, as a research university, no doubt about it. But as I say many times, repeatedly say, you know, in our country, I believe that the main challenge is that we are facing is not the Iranian bomb. And excuse me, all the generals, you know, and all the experts for security. I believe that the main challenge is to create common denominator to all the sub-segments of the Israeli society. It's nothing to do with political affiliation. It's a must. You know, multiculturalism is a challenge for any community in the world. You know, we see what is going in the United States, in Europe, and many other places in the world. But for us in Israel, a tiny country, this challenge or the inequality and the tension between the subsegments of the Israeli society is one challenge too much. So it's nothing. Yes, of course it's a matter of values, but also it's a matter of utmost interest. If we want to survive as a country in this corner of the world. So when we are here with our neighbors, the Druze community, and we are good neighbors, and many students that we have are from this community, and I see here Rafik Halabi, my friend, the mayor, and also the mayor of Haifa, Yona Yav, and of course his wife, Rivka, our faculty, our professor, and many other guests and supporters. You know, the role of a president sometimes is a lonely one. But when I have you here with me, I definitely feel that I'm not alone. We are privileged that we have you as our supporters, because without you, we wouldn't have accomplished what we had, and we still have a lot of challenges. Now I will shorten my speech, because tomorrow, I warn you in advance, my report will take some 35 minutes. So be with us tomorrow. Thank you very much, and good evening. And shukran lakum.
Thank you, Mr. Amos Shapira, mostly for the compliments. Thank you. And now we have a performance by Dalet El Karmel Folk Group. Amin Natour is on the oud, is a self-trained musician and composer. He is accompanied by his son Naif on the daf. They will be performing two songs. The first is by Faiza Ahmed, My Heart Loves You, and the second is sung by Kalthoum, Balad El Mahboub. It's a song about a homeland. It could be this Carmel Mountain and also the state of Israel. touching. The links between Dalet el-Karmel and the neighboring villages and the university go back to when the university was set up. Mayor Abakhushi met with the leaders of Dalet el-Karmel and Sofia, encouraging parents to send their high school children to the university. Links were forged with schools in both towns, encouraging local teachers as well as students to register for academic studies. They organized tours by the student union and even gifted books for the school library to commemorate a fallen Druze soldier in 1969. That bond remains close till today. It is personified by our next speaker, leader of the Dalet el-Karmel Council, Rafiq Halabi. Mr. Rafiq Halabi is a former journalist, a winner of the House of Lords and Sokol of Media Awards. He has and was a lecturer at the Department of Communication and is collaborating with the university on a project where top students in local schools meet with our faculty. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to Mr. Rafiq Halabi.
I'm so proud. Dua is a teacher in our village. Thank you, Dua. Aduni Rosh Ha'ir, Professor Alfred Tauber, Ami, Amos Shapira Edidi, Professor David Faraji, friends and faculty. I already have a written speech, but I'll put it aside. Yesterday, we closed May of Culture. When we talk about culture, we mean how we live and how we want to live. Israel, our state, has a lot of communities, different communities, unique communities. The Druze community is one of them. We still, even in these days, struggling for getting the equal rights. To get coexistence, first of all, we have to talk about equal rights and justice. But we still believe that this state is not only our state, it's the only and the one and the only that we defend and we create and we build together with other Israelis. We live in these days, we can see, we can watch in these days how hard could be the other culture. Just look aside and watch what's going on in Syria. Our friends, our families slaughtered, victimed, and murdered in name of God. And here, we are trying to create not only pluralism, democracy, and freedom. The city of Haifa, the city of Yonah Yahav, is a symbol for this coexistence. The University of Haifa, with about 20% non-Jewish students, is a symbol of coexistence. So I'm not going to speak about our life in this country, but I want just from this stage to ask all of the leaders in Israel and in Palestine just to check hand and to create the process for getting peace, because only peace can save this country and the Middle East. Thank you.
Amir Rafiq, could you please stay there a moment? Could you go back to stage? Thank you. Well, thank you to Mr. Rafiq Halabi. Please stay with us, of course. The university is so appreciative of your words, your generous contribution to this event, and of course to your friendship. As a mark of our appreciation, I would like to invite President Amos Shapira, where are you? And Vice President of Development and External Relations, Yariv Sultan, to present you with a small gift. We would like also to add a special thanks to Nuzhat Awad of Rafiq Halabi's office and to Eyal Hadid for the lovely venue. Around this time last year, the latest of war was looming. In the summer, thousands of young people, including young men from this village, were drafted to serve in the Operation Protective Edge. Dear friends, we thank you all for who supported our students who were drafted in our time of need with the Operation Protective Edge scholarships for students and for faculty members who serve for duty.
תחילת הכניסה הקרקעית של צוק איתן, אני נמצא בברלין, בשותפות שיש לנו עם אוניברסיטת חיפה, עם השריטה ומכון מקס פלנק, ואני מקבל טלפון. אנחנו נכנסים פנימה, אנחנו צריכים שתחזור, אין לנו חיילים.
שלושה ימים אחרי שהתחיל מבצע צוק איתן, קיבלתי טלפון ממערך המילואים, אמרו לי להתייצב ב-8 בבוקר ביחידה שלי בחיל הים, ובאותו יום היה לי מבחן בבוקר. אז זה היה ממש בלחץ, הגעתי ישר מפה אחרי המבחן ליחידה בעצם, נסעתי לאשדוד. חותך באוויר בין הבתים
יוצא לאור אל חיים חדש. אלה היו מאוד שמחים, אני הייתי הבחור היחיד שרצה לחזור לארץ. אשתי קצת פחות שמחה. אבל לא היה לי שום ספק שאני חוזר. הגעתי הביתה, החלפתי תיקים וירדתי דרומה. קצת אחר כך כבר נכנסנו.
ירדנו לחמל, התחלנו לעשות את מה שאנחנו עושות שם בדרך כלל, שזה להיות בקשר עם כל הכוחות הימיים. בגלל שזה חיל הים ואין חומה, גדר, הקשר בין הכלים לחוף הוא מאוד מאוד קריטי וחשוב.
ההחלטה הייתה שאנחנו הולכים לתפוס את המחבלים שיוצאים מהמנהרות באזור שלנו, של ישראל. מקמנו על הגבול הדרומי של הרצועה, בעצם כל לילה יצאנו החוצה בתקווה למצוא אותם לפני שהם מוצאים אותנו. הבעיה הגדולה מאוד עם זה היא שכל הזמן נופלים עליך טילים. אתה לא מוגן, אתה שוכב בתוך החול.
היינו במשמרת וראינו במסכים מישהו שבעצם שני אנשים שעברו את החוף דרך הים למעשה, צללו מתחת לגדר. הבנו די מהר ככה שמדובר בשני, בחוליית מחבלים ולא בבן אדם תמים. יצרנו קשר עם הכוחות האוויריים ועם הכוחות שבים, ואנחנו למעשה במצלמות עקבנו אחריהם כל הזמן הזה ודאגנו שהם לא יעזבו את השדה ראייה שלנו לרגע כדי שנוכל באמת לטפל באירוע הזה כמו שצריך. התחושה הייתה מאוד אמוציונלית, מאוד לחץ, לחץ מאוד גדול. ואתה מבין כמה אחריות יש לך על הכתפיים, וכמה זה משמעותי, ומה הם יכולים, מה המשמעות של זה בעצם, מה הם יכולים לעשות כשהם חצו את הגבול הזה.
ברגעים האלה שאני שם, בהתחלה הייתי מאוד רגוע. ולאט לאט זה חלחל. בבית יש לי אישה, חודש שמיני בהיריון, ילדה ראשונה, אף פעם לא חשבתי על זה עד אז. ופתאום הפחד הוא לא פחד לעצמך, הוא פחד לזה שאני לא אחזור. פחד לזה שהילדה שלי תגדל בלי אבא. פחד לזה שאשתי תצטרך להיות אם חד-הורית. פתאום הדאגה היא לזה שאני הבטחתי שאני אחזור ושאני באמת צריך לעמוד במילה שלי. מילואים זה משהו שאני אעשה תמיד, זה החווה שלי למדינה הזאת, זה החיות שלי במדינה הזאת, זה הזכות שלי במדינה הזאת, להיות חייל מילואים.
אתה יודע שאתה עושה תפקיד מאוד חשוב, אתה שומר על החיילים שנמצאים בפנים, אתה שומר על האזרחים שנמצאים בחוץ, וזה שליחות.
אחרי 32 יום של לחימה, מבצע נגמר ואני חוזר הביתה. קצת אחר כך נולדת מיקה, בת הבכורה שלנו. ובמקביל אני מקבל עוד ידיעה מאוד משמחת. אני מקבל את מלגת צוק איתן מהאוניברסיטה.
זה נותן תחושה מאוד, מאוד נעימה, מאוד חמה, מאוד שכולנו עם אחד וכולנו, והם צריכים, הם מבינים את התחושה בעצם שאנחנו עוברים פה ומנסים לעזור כמה שהם יכולים, וזה משהו שהוא ראוי להערכה רבה מאוד.
הידיעה הזאת שמישהו חושב עלינו, שמישהו רוצה לעזור לנו, שמישהו איתנו בחזית, מאפשר לי לדעת שפעם הבאה אני תמיד אלך גם כן, כי אני לא הולך לבד. מישהו בא איתי. אני רוצה להגיד לאנשים האלה, תודה.
My name is Navot Naor, and as you just seen in the movie, for the better part of a year, I'm a PhD student here at the university. But for a few days each year, I switch my lab coat for a uniform. Then I find myself dealing with things a world away from my research, which is focused on the positive aspects of the human experience, such as love, happiness, and empathy. We Israelis tend to start our higher education later than most students in the world. After a year of national service, 4 years in the army, and 2 years traveling the world, I was 26 the day I set foot in the university for the first time. Already lagging behind and needing to catch up. Being forced to leave my work half done was everything but conducive to the effort of catching up. A year later, I'm a proud father. I have returned to Berlin and furthered my project, and the work has started to bear fruits. That, however, would not have been the case if financial concerns were added to the mix of being a student, a family man, and a soldier. It is heartwarming beyond description to learn that somewhere, someone, you, think of us, of our sacrifice and of the price that we pay. And just like us, the students who were here and me, who did not hesitate to answer the call and went to protect this country, you did not hesitate to protect us. For that, we would like to thank you. Thank you for believing in us. Thank you for thinking of us. Thank you for caring.
Thank you, Navot Naor. Your story really brought to life what students like you have to deal with and how much the scholarship meant. Tonight, we focus on those who give back, as our friends do, and of those who find their own way to give back to their community, especially on campus. Some who can see all this in a person responsible for the overall care of all of our students on campus, the Dean of Students. It is my pleasure to invite Professor Hanan Alexander, Dean of Students, to the stage.
Good evening, everyone, and what an extraordinary evening it is. We've heard a lot this evening about the challenges of creating an excellent research university in the context of diversity that's represented by this wonderful setting. But the truth is, I don't see diversity as a challenge for academic excellence. Diversity of our student body and our faculty is not a challenge, but an asset. It makes the University of Haifa an extraordinarily wonderful place to teach, in which students ask unbelievably challenging questions that come from all over the map, from this culture and from that culture and from this religious tradition and from another religious tradition. It creates the foundation of what is truly a beacon of light and an excellent university among the very best, certainly in Israel, and reaching to be among the best around the world. At the heart of our work as a university is a wonderful student body, a student body that's expressed in a variety of student activities across campus, in a student leadership forum, in a wonderful student union. The president of the student union, Amit Sheffer, is here this evening, and we have an excellent relationship between the university and the student union that's a long history and tradition that will continue. An initiative of the student union this year, of which I'm particularly proud, an agenda called B'Haifa Midabrim V'lo Mifachadim. In Haifa, we talk to one another, we're not afraid, in which the student union leadership under Amit's initiative have brought together all of the student groups, Arab and Jewish alike, to speak together to create a common amana, a common contract amongst one another in order to figure out how to live together. This is really the spirit of the University of Haifa. It's an extraordinary spirit, and it makes us an excellent university. In that spirit, the heart of all of our student activities are in the dormitories. The dormitories are kind of our hothouse of multiculturalism and pluralism. And so some years ago, we decided that we wanted to have the opportunity to recognize the outstanding Israeli citizen in our microcosm of Israeli society. And we do that each year with the Citizenship Prize of the University of Haifa. And it's my pleasure now to invite Osnat Weinstein, who's the director of housing at the university, and Eden Lichner, who's the recipient of this year's prize, to the stage. I'm going to let Osnat read the citation in Hebrew, and then I'll summarize it in English, and then we'll be happy to award the prize.
Pras Ezrachut Yisraelit Lemofet, Mu'anak LaStudent Dayar HaMe'onot Eden Lichner. על תרומתו האישית לקהיליית דיירי המעונות באוניברסיטת חיפה, על רוח ההתנדבות והירתמות בכל עת לסיוע, לאם הבית ולדיירים, תוך יצירת דיאלוג ושיח רב תרבותי. כל זאת בצניעות, מסירות וחיוך רחב.
So the citation is the prize for a model Israeli citizen at the University of Haifa, granted this year to Eden Lichner for his... I now have to read this for his volunteer for his spirit of community and volunteership as a member of the student community in the dormitories, for his willingness to help the Em Habayit, the house mother, and all of the students in the dormitories in a spirit of dialogue and multiculturalism, all this with modesty and dedication and a big, big smile. Eden Mazal Tov.
Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Alexander, Mrs. Winston, and congratulations to you, Eden. It's really a very big kiff. Enjoy it. You are a real role model for all of us. And now, to end this evening in Dalet al-Karmel, we have one of the delights of the Druze culture, the Dibka dance. The Dibka is a traditional dance which the whole community dance at weddings or other joyous occasions. In fact, it used to be danced when men came back from war, too. The Dibka is about joy, unity, and community, things which I feel are very much apparent tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the Dibka.
دلعونا طيبي الغرب الوطن حنونا بالي غير لحال بعدك عبالي بسمر الوكرك
close. You're invited to help yourselves to dessert and coffee, and in the Debka put you in a mood like it did with me for dancing. The music and dance will continue after a while. But before we end, I'd like to thank everyone who participated in this event, who helped in all the preparations, to everyone who spoke tonight, and to every special thank you to Mr. Atif Kayouf for all the assistance and guidance in preparing this event tonight and helping everything become a reality. Most of all, thank you for joining us here, for being our friends, friends of the university, and for sharing your commitment to learning. We look forward to an exciting few days where we hope we can show you how much your gifts mean to us. So I will have to say thank you in Arabic first, which is shukran, and then I would have to say good night. You're invited to the Debka.
One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three.